I'm Matt Powell from the Solidworks training team. When working on Solidworks xShape, you are constantly selecting a group of faces, vertices, and edges. In this video, I'll go over 10 selection tips that may help you with your workflow. Let's get started. Here, I'm editing a subdivision body using Solidworks xShape. For the first and second tip, you can double-click on an edge or face to select a loop. When double-clicking a face, the direction changes depending on where you double-click. If you double-click near the top or bottom edge of the face loop will wrap around vertically. If you double-click near the left or right edge of the face loop will wrap around horizontally. Tip number 3 has to do with box selection. I'm going to pin my selection to only select faces, but this works for all other entities as well. If I left-click and drag to the right, you can see that my box selection is orange. And if I let go, it will only select the faces that is fully in that box. If I left-click and drag to the left, you can see that my box selection is blue. And if I let go, all of the faces touching that box will be selected. Now, when I made this selection, the faces behind the model are also selected. But what if I wanted to select only the entities that I see and nothing else behind it? That brings me to tip number 4. I can activate select only visible elements in the subdivision work area. Now, if I do roughly the same selection as before, only the entities I see on screen will be selected. But wait, there's more. Let's say you like using the lasso selection rather than the box selection. For tip 5, when you're creating a box selection, you can go back to your starting point and your mouse will switch to the lasso. The same rules apply where if you start the lasso to the right, you get an orange selection. And if you start the lasso to the left, you get a blue selection. For tip 6, if you have face loop selection pinned and you want to switch the direction of the loop after clicking on a face, just press O on your keyboard. I'll pin my selection back to all entities. For tip 7, if I click on an edge and press I on my keyboard, it will select the edge rings. For tip 8, I can highlight multiple entities at once with box selection by holding down the shift key. If I highlight an entity by accident, I can hold down the alt key to subtract the entities from my selection. For the final tip, you can hover your cursor over the subdivision work area buttons to see other selection options. You'll get a tooltip on what they do, and some of the selection options mentioned in this video are here as well. And that's 10 selection tips on SolidWorks xShape. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this content helpful, visit the site in the description below to access more content on SolidWorks xShape.